Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through priority interrupts. So basically we have already learned what is an interrupt, so let us recap that thing. So interrupt, it is a signal or a condition, guys. So basically in the once that interrupt is generated, the CPU stops its current instruction and it saves that address and completes the interrupt request program and return back to the main program. The flow will be like the CPU. When interrupt raised to interrupt code, it executes that and it returns back to the starting ending of the interrupt and it continues the program. Fine? Okay. CPU cannot transfer unless the peripheral devices are ready for transfer. Okay. So basically it is very likely that there will be more than one device connected to a computer system, each having the ability to generate interrupt request. So basically for our system, basically we will be connecting USB drives, those are nothing but we'll be connecting mouse, keyboard, some kind of pen drives whenever we need, some other hard drives whenever we need. So each and everything will be generating some kind of signals, guys. Those are nothing but interrupt signals. So the priority will be in this format. For magnetic disks and high speed devices, it will be having high priority, whereas keyboard, mouse and those low priority things, it will be having the low priority. Fine. Okay, so basically interrupts are further divided into two types, guys. Those are nothing but hardwired interrupts, software interrupts. Hardware interrupts are nothing from an external device like keyboard or any kind of interrupts, guys. Okay, so software interrupts are nothing but caused internally by the system. Fine. Okay, if you take the example of an external interrupt, it is nothing but when you press a shift in a keyboard, guys, press it 10 to 20 times, you'll be getting an interrupt or you'll be getting an error that multiple pressing of shift, it is a sticky key, please use it properly, something you'll be getting a message like that. Fine. So that is a hardwired interrupt. So in that there are two cases, maskable and non-maskable. Maskable are nothing but if high priority is there, then this will be waiting. Non-maskable means it cannot be delayed. So maskable and non-maskable means maskable can be paused or delayed for some time, guys. Whereas non-maskable should be done right at that moment. Fine? Okay. So now I hope everyone got a small idea. Further moving on, software interrupts. Okay, we have discussed this also. They are further divided into normal and exceptional. So normal are nothing but interrupt caused by the instructions of certain instructions interrupts, guys. So the other case will be execution, that is nothing but applied when interrupted at runtime, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on interrupts and priority interrupts. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going in detailed about DMA, that is nothing but direct memory access. Thank you. Thanks for watching.